This video will give you an introduction on radiation protection dosimetry. Basically, it deals with quantifying the health effects induced by the radiation to which radiation workers, for instance, in a nuclear or medical field, are being exposed. Why do we actually need radiation protection dosimetry? Well, ionizing radiation can induce a variety of detrimental health effects such as skin burns, cataract, or cancer. These effects fall in two categories. Firstly, we have the deterministic effects, such as burns, cataract, and in very severe cases, also hair loss and organ failure. These effects all have a certain threshold dose. Below the threshold dose, these effects do not occur at all, while above the threshold, they occur with certainty, and the severity increases with the dose. Deterministic effects typically appear immediately. Only cataract needs some decades to develop. Besides the deterministic effects, we also have the stochastic effects, such as cancer and inheritable effects. These have no threshold dose and can occur even at very low doses. On the basis of epidemiological studies, it is usually assumed that the chance for stochastic effects increases linearly with the dose. So in contrast to the deterministic effects, it is now the probability and not the severity of the effects that increases with the dose. Stochastic effects typically also need several decades to develop. It is thus clear that we have to protect radiation workers against these health effects. Radiation protection is based on three pillars. Firstly, one should always justify the use of radiation. Secondly, one should always keep radiation dose as low as reasonably achievable. This is known as the ALARA principle. And thirdly, legal dose limits are imposed, such that deterministic effects cannot occur and the chance for stochastic effects remains at a tolerable level. Both the ALARA principle and the dose limits require, of course, that we have measurable quantities quantifying the radiation-induced health effects. This is where radiation protection dosimetry comes into play. How can we express and measure the radiation doses to which workers are being exposed? In order to properly quantify radiation-induced health effects, three aspects have to be taken into account. Firstly, the amount of radiation energy deposited in each of the tissues of the exposed body has to be assessed. This is characterized for each tissue by the organ absorbed dose. This quantity gives you the amount of radiation energy deposited in the tissue T per unit of mass. It is expressed in joule per kilogram, which has been given a special name, gray. Secondly, one has to take into account the harmfulness of radiation. Some radiation types, such as photons and electrons, have a low ionization density on the scale of a DNA molecule. This gives rise to simple DNA damage that can usually be repaired by the body. On the other hand, radiation types, such as alphas and heavier nuclei, have a much larger ionization density. This gives rise to very complex DNA damage that is much more difficult for the body to repair and thus more harmful. The harmfulness of each radiation type R is taken into account by the radiation weighing factor. This quantity expresses how much more damaging a radiation type is in comparison for photons for the same organ absorbed doses. It is a dimensionless number. As you can see in the table on the left, electrons and muons have the same weighing factor as photons. Protons and charged pions are 2 times more harmful. Alphas and heavier nuclei even are 20 times more harmful. For neutrons, the weighing factor depends on the energy, as shown in the plot on the right, and ranges about 2.5 up to slightly above 20. Thirdly, for stochastic effects, one has to take into account the radiosensitivity of the affected tissues. The radiosensitivity of each tissue is expressed by the tissue weighing factor. This quantity expresses which fraction of the stochastic effects occurs in tissue T for a uniform whole body radiation exposure and is again a dimensionless number. In the table on the left, you can see, for instance, that there's 12 times more chance for stochastic effects in the red bone marrow or in the stomach than in the brain or the skin. Now, with the organ absorbed dose, the radiation and tissue weighing factors, we can construct the two main quantities of radiation protection dosimetry. The deterministic effects in a tissue T are quantified by the organ equivalent dose. This first quantity is calculated by multiplying the organ absorbed dose for a tissue T with the radiation weighing factor. and sum the contributions for the different radiation types. It is expressed in joule per kilogram, and it has been given the special name sievert. In some specific workplaces, such as nuclear medicine and interventional radiology, the hands and the eyelids are the most exposed tissues of the worker's body. As these tissues are more sensitive for deterministic effects than for stochastic effects, one monitors the organ equivalent dose. This is done with small luminescent radiation detectors worn in a ring holder at the base of the index or on a band around the head, as close to the eye as possible. The stochastic effects for the whole body combined are quantified by the total effective dose. This second quantity is calculated by multiplying the organ equivalent doses for all tissues with the tissue weighing factor, and then sum all the contributions for all tissues. The effective dose is also expressed in sievert. Epidemiological studies have shown that there is about 5% additional cancer risk per sievert of effective dose. So multiplying the effective dose with 5% gives you an indication of the additional cancer risk induced by the radiation exposure. The effective dose is monitored for all radiation workers. This is done with a compact passive whole body dose meter worn at chest level. Most whole body dose meters are also based on luminescent detectors. It is also possible to place environmental dose meters at a certain location to estimate the effective dose to which people there will be exposed. Workers at risk of internal contamination with radionuclides also have to be monitored for internal radiation exposure. For gamma emitters, this is done by measurement of the worker with an external detector close to the body. For pure alpha and beta emitters, this is done by dissolving urine samples in scintillation liquid. Such measurements allow calculating the committed effective dose to which the worker will be exposed over the course of his life due to incorporation of radionuclides in his body. So now you've had a first glimpse on the complexity and importance of radiation protection dosimetry.